So many of you were loving this video, so I thought we definitely need to make an easier, chocolatier version of this before summer is over. This recipe doesn't use any refined sugar. Of course, it's super low fat and all vegan. You guys know I love using sweet potatoes as the base for sweet desserts because they are so sweet. And when you bake them, they become even sweeter and they are just so creamy and delicious. And especially when paired with chocolate, they just make the perfect dessert. So in my last video, I showed you guys how to make them into ice cream, and today we are going to do something even easier than that. We are going to make them into chocolate popsicles, fudgesicles, choco pops, whatever you want to call them, and they're going to be delicious. All we're going to need for today's recipe is our baked sweet potato. These are so easy to make a batch of. I just roast them in the oven at 400 degrees with a couple holes poked in them for about 45 minutes. We are also going to need some unsweetened non-dairy milk. I like soy milk, but you can also use almond milk, oat milk, rice milk, coconut milk, whatever kind of milk you like. And then we are going to need a sweetener. I like maple syrup, but you can also use softened dates. And I will actually link the recipe modifications in the description box below in case you wanted to swap one of these out for another. And then of course, to make our chocolate flavor, you will also need some cocoa powder, but you could also use raw cacao if you prefer. And then these last two ingredients are optional. I just find that they enhance the flavor a little bit, so I like to use them, but if you don't have them, don't worry about it. But if you do want a flavor boost, then I would recommend trying some vanilla extract and a pinch of salt. Of course, once you feel comfortable with this recipe, you can also play around by adding in some other flavors, such as mint to make a mint chocolate popsicle, or you could add in a little bit of coffee or coffee extract to make like a mocha flavored fudgesicle, or you could even add like a vanilla and strawberry layer to it and make a Neapolitan popsicle. That actually sounds really good. I might have to try that in another video, but today we are just gonna stick with the basic chocolate recipe. So into the blender, we are going to add our two medium-sized sweet potatoes. This is about 2 cups. They weighed out to be 265 grams once the skins were removed, but honestly, this recipe is really forgiving, so don't worry too much about exact measurements. And to that, we are going to add 1.5 cups soy milk, 1/3 cup cocoa powder, 1/3 cup maple syrup, 1/2 teaspoon vanilla, and a pinch of salt. Okay, this next part is very important. You're going to want to taste your mixture and make sure it is sweet enough, it has enough chocolate flavor, and anything else you may need to add. You guys know I always say taste as you go, so just give it a little taste. Oh, the consistency is beautiful. Now, obviously, we could just even turn this into a pudding. I do have a recipe for that. It's basically the same. I'll link it up here and in the description box below. And let's go ahead and give this a taste. So chocolatey and good. Now, if you did want it a little bit sweeter, you could add a little bit more maple syrup and or dates. My husband does like it on the sweeter side, so if I was making it for him, I would add a little bit more maple syrup, but I'm making this one for me. And then also the same with the cocoa powder. If it is not chocolatey enough, add more cocoa powder. If your mixture is too thick, make sure you add a little bit more plant milk. And if it is too thin, you can always add in some extra sweet potato. But this is the consistency we want it, very pudding-like, but still very liquidy. And it will pour into our molds perfectly. And now we're just gonna pour our mixture into our popsicle molds. Once your molds are filled, you're going to want to find some space in your overcrowded freezer. And now we wait. Oh, wait. If you do have any left over, if you run out of popsicle molds, you can just refrigerate this and turn it into pudding, like I said, or you know, you can just eat it right now as a healthy little snack while you're waiting. And meanwhile, try not to get it all over your hands. Okay, I believe these are frozen. It has been about 2.5, almost 3 hours. Ooh, it might be a little soft still. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. Okay, I definitely could have let them go a little bit longer. I think they're a little bit soft, but it was frozen enough to stay together. I think maybe next time, at least 3 hours, maybe longer. Of course, overnight would be the best, but I was too impatient. Let's go ahead and give it a taste. So good. Oh my goodness. It has been so hot here lately. These are perfect for summer, or I guess really an anytime kind of treat. You guys saw they are so easy to make. They are super healthy and very, very delicious. And if you're looking for any of the other healthy vegan ice creams, check out the description box down below. I will have that playlist linked down there. And of course, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Let's eat plants, and I will see you guys next time.